What a lineup.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. We're here to help you find your way around the sky tonight. So, Dean, are you excited?
I'm very excited. Wait, what am I excited about?
The planetary alignment we've been talking about for months between Jupiter and Venus.
Oh yeah, on June 30th. It's almost here.
Yes, and before that, to get even more excited, the moon will join the dance and pass by Venus, Jupiter, and the bright star Regulus.
A moon, star, and planets lineup? I'll be honest, I was just pretending to be excited before, but now, let's see it.
Okay, we have our sky set up for Sunday, June 21st at 9 p.m. facing west. The sun is about to set, but you can just make out the waxing crescent moon hanging in the southwestern sky.
As we run time forward, we can make the sun set. Then, the brightest stars will begin to pop out. There's Venus, the brightest star-like object in the sky, often called the evening star, since for months at a time, you can see it right after the sun sets in the west. Wish I may, wish I might, first star I see tonight is really a planet.
Venus is so incredibly bright in our sky because one, it's a planet almost 8,000 miles across. Two, it's relatively close to us at about 55 million miles. And three, it's covered in highly reflective clouds that bounce the sunlight back to us.
As the sun sets further and the sky gets darker, the next star that will pop into view is not a star either. I'll give you some hints. It's the fifth planet from the sun, the largest planet in the solar system, and rhymes with Moopiter.
Wow, good hints, Dean. I think they figured out that this is the planet Jupiter. Jupiter is a gas giant planet 88,000 miles in diameter. That means you could fit 11 Earths across its equator.
Jupiter is mainly made of hydrogen and helium gases, so there is no land to stand on when you visit. But above the cloud tops of Jupiter, you'd have an amazing view of its four largest moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto.
You can see Jupiter and the four moons from Earth as well, when you look through any quality telescope.
Once we advance time to about 10:30 p.m. or so, the sky has gotten dark enough to see more of the stars in the sky. The brightest star in the west at this time of night and this time of year is called Regulus.
Regulus is the brightest star in the constellation of Leo the Lion. It marks the heart of the lion and shines with a bright blue-white light.
Here's the deal with Regulus. It's about 77 light years away, 3.8 times more massive than our sun, and about three times as wide. Despite its size, Regulus spins incredibly fast, making one complete turn in less than 16 hours.
Astronomers believe that there's a white dwarf star very close to Regulus, which orbits every 40 hours. Regulus' speedy rotation rate, combined with the tug from the little star, has made Regulus look decidedly squished. Instead of a sphere, Regulus looks more like an M&M.
So there is our lineup for next week. Venus, Jupiter, Regulus, and the moon. Of course, the moon will only be there temporarily, and as the days go on, the planets will wander.
By June 26th, Venus and Jupiter will be appearing really close together, and Regulus will be gaining on them as well.
And then on the evening of the 30th, right after dark, you'll see Venus and Jupiter so close together that they may be hard to separate.
Into July, the threesome will only be visible lower in the sky, and Venus will move to the middle.
And way in the future, on July 18th, the moon returns to this part of the sky and seems to skim right by Venus. Another lineup with a different order about a month from now.
So start getting excited for the great Venus-Jupiter conjunction on June 30th.
You can get a preview of the coming attraction just after sunset this week when Venus, Jupiter, Regulus, and the moon will all line up. Keep looking up.